What's going on, friends? It's Jonathan. I've been using a Mac Mini server now for a few months. Being that this is my first real server, I've been really impressed by its performance. I figure it's about time for me to tell you about what I have going on. I'm gonna break this down with what I use to set up my Mac Mini server, the benefits of having one, and how I maintenance it to make sure everything is polished and stays fully functional. Speaking of maintenance, I just wanna give a quick shout out to this video's sponsor, Clean My Mac X. Clean My Mac is an all-in-one application that can free up space and improve the speed of your Mac just by a simple click of a button. It clears out massive amounts of junk files, protects your computer from Mac-specific threats, and optimizes your Mac for day one-like performance. It's so good that Apple themselves backed this software and notarizes it, which means it's legit. If you want to find out more about Clean My Mac and how it can help you with your Mac Mini server, stay tuned. First off, just a quick disclaimer, I understand that there's many ways to build a Mac Mini server, and there are some out there that are way more extensive and functional versus what I have going on here. However, I'm open to any advice that you guys want to give me on things that I should change or add to my setup to really improve it, make it a little bit more capable and more functional. Just leave it down below in the comment section. I'm looking forward to what you guys have to say. So to get started, you need a Mac Mini. Of course, that's like the heart of the setup. But you don't have to go with the latest and greatest. You can get like a 2012, 2013 model. You can get them used off eBay for really cheap. And if you don't trust eBay, Amazon has quite a few good prices. I'll link a few down in the description. You also need an Ethernet cable, a router, a modem, an internet connection, and some software to set up your server on your Mac Mini. Setting up the hardware is as simple as connecting your Mac Mini to your router using an Ethernet cable. Once it's connected, make sure that your primary source to the internet is through your Ethernet port and not through Wi-Fi. You can verify this in your network settings. Now that that's done, you're gonna wanna pick the software that you're gonna use to set up your Mac Mini server. In my case, I went with the MacOS server software, which can be downloaded in the Mac App Store for like $19.99. Setting up the macOS server app was extremely simple. It's basically just following some on-screen prompts and then going into your settings and enabling a few permissions. That's it. The most important thing is to make sure the Mac Mini doesn't go to sleep, power down, or go to the lock screen after it's been sitting for a while. Also, make sure you enable the setting for your Mac Mini to turn on and log in automatically if the power were to go out. That's pretty much it in terms of the setup. It's really simple. Now, of course, this isn't a tutorial or a walkthrough, so I skipped quite a bit, but there are plenty of great videos on YouTube that walk you through the entire process. I'll link a couple down in the description, but it is really easy. There are a ton of useful applications for a Mac Mini server. I'm not even scratching the surface at what it's fully capable of, so I dropped a link down in the description that will take you to a website giving you many, many more use cases and applications that you can download to use with your Mac Mini server. For me, first and foremost, I'm using it to run my Air message server. That way I can get my iMessages on any device that I want to receive them on. Let me quickly clarify that by any device, I mean any device that is capable of having AirMessage installed on it. I'm also using it for file storage and as a NAS. I have my LaCie 2Big RAID hooked up to my Mac Mini. I allow network access to my external drives within the system preferences. And using Transit 5, I turn my Mac Mini into not only a local network storage solution, but also remote. What's nice about the 2Big RAID is that if I were to use my Mac Mini locally, the 2Big RAID has fast and consistent speeds for video editing, even H.264 4K in Final Cut Pro 10. More so, if I'm running low on space, upgrading is as easy as opening up the front bays and replacing them with LaCie-approved enterprise-class drives. I did a video demonstrating the LaCie 2Big RAID and the LaCie 2Big dock. I'll link it in a card at the top. When it comes to mobile access, I'm using FE Explorer. This gives me the ability to transfer files to and from my iPhone and iPad remotely. In the future, I plan on adding an eGPU with a Radeon 7 to my Mac Mini and use it as like a renderer. That way I can push my video project from my MacBook Pro or my iMac Pro to my Mac Mini and render it out depending on if it has a lot of effects. If it's a simple render, then yeah, I'll just push it to my Mac Mini. This will free up the machine that I'm currently on so I can start another edit. Servicing and maintaining my Mac Mini server has been a breeze so far. One of the most important things to me is keeping it clear of clutter and making sure that there's no junk files that are being stored on my server. To do that, I'm turning to this video's sponsor, which is Clean My Mac. Clean My Mac is an excellent way to ensure my Mac Mini server is running at peak performance. It's an all-in-one package to delete junk files, find hidden apps and folders, neutralizes keylogging malware, it manages hung apps and apps that consume a large amount of CPU resources, and it ensures all of my software is up to date with the latest versions. And since I can access my Mac Mini server locally plus remotely and share the screen, I can run all of these scans routinely. Clean My Mac puts an icon in the top menu bar that displays the status of my machine, including memory used, storage, CPU temps, and network performance. So if you want to experience the full capabilities of this software, check down below in the description for a link to a free trial. Since my server is always connected to the internet, that means it's always exposed to potential malware threats. So another form of maintenance for me is to ensure that I have the latest and greatest malware protection and firewall capabilities. For that, I'm using Bitdefender Total Security 2019. It performs system scans automatically, removes any possible threats by deletion or by quarantine, and it limits access to certain files and folders. This is extremely important considering I have multiple people accessing my server all of the time. I can also schedule Time Machine backups and protect those backups from possible corruption or malware. In my opinion, this is the most important part of this video because you're not just protecting your server, you're protecting your household. You don't want any creepos getting access to your cameras in your home, your tablets, your laptops, your computers, your phones, all that stuff. Stay protected. I can save you some money. I can give you 90 days free of the latest version of Total Security. All you gotta do is click the link in the description, sign up, get that free 90-day trial, and experience it yourself. If you wanna know my favorite features of Total Security, click the card at the top of this video. Other than software maintenance, I also make sure I log into my Mac Mini once a week to ensure everything is up and running as it should be and clear any notifications. I also turn it off for a couple hours when I'm home and no one is using the server to perform a quick physical cleaning like dust removal and also for the system to rest. I do this about once every month or so. So yeah, friends, that's my Mac Mini server. I absolutely love it. I definitely want some more functionality and capabilities out of it, so I plan on doing some follow-up content as I add on to the server. If you're interested in that type of content, make sure to subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you have any advice for me, leave it down below in the comment section, and I will talk to you thuggin', Mac Mini lovin', server pluggin' individuals in the next video. So let's go ahead and answer a few questions that you guys asked me in the last video. Roxanne asked, can you talk about your tattoos? Also, what brand of hat is that? It's dope. Thank you. It's actually a Fox hat. I love Fox clothing. I don't wear their shirts, but I love their shorts, and I absolutely love, love, love their hats. In terms of my tattoos, I have several, but the one that you guys probably see the most is my sleeve here. And this is actually the story of Little Red Riding Hood. People are wolves in sheep clothing, so you gotta be careful who you trust, otherwise you'll get bit. XXNike629XX. What's the best budget equipment for starting up a YouTube channel? This is a very interesting question, and depending who you ask, you're probably gonna get a different answer. For me, your phone. You want the cheapest way to start a YouTube channel? Use your phone, and instead of researching budget equipment, spend that time researching tutorials on coloring, on framing, on lighting, and use what you have. Save your money, and then buy gear that's going to last you versus buying cheap gear that's gonna be temporary. Maybe I'll do a video on all this. Next question is from Quick Mind. What about something to grip the camera from below? Maybe a pistol grip or a mini tripod, something light. I got you. This is an iFootage Cobra 2 monopod, and it's got a little secret. The bottom can pop off, and then the top can also